can calm from depression?
Of course.
Okay, okay. Now, I have done a lot of research on depression, okay? I know that, then we have coffee break, coffee right, okay? We have this helpless model of depression, the focus on efficacy, and then we have hopeless model of depression, you know, the emphasis on restoring hope. But based on my research, what is most effective to combat depression is to discover something that's meaningful in your life. You know, to re-experience meaning, do something meaningful, like restore relationship with a friend, or achieve some success in your pursuit of career. The often people are depressed because all they experience is failure, loss. If you keep on experiencing loss, failure, the breaking point for everybody, you snap, right? So what I'm saying is that the meaning approach is to begin the baby step, but with a larger goal, a baby step to experience success as in doing something meaningful. At the end of the day, you reflect it today, whatever then make me feel good, you know, either random kindness, or express gratitude, or apologize to someone, whatever then today that make me feel good. You were able to keep a record about that, the simple recipe. I guarantee you feel less depressed. You know, just simple, yes. Yeah, this is what I'm trying to say, that simple exercise, right? Gratitude, forgiveness, kindness. Do something for helping other people, you know, like helping others, altruism, prayer. You know, do anything that's meaningful to you and make you feel good. If you're doing that, it doesn't matter how bad the situation, because those things are within your control, right? You can always say, "Ken, I'm so happy that you give such a helpful lecture. I'm so happy. Oh, Dr. Akbar, I'm so happy you're here. You make my day." Oh, if you're able to say something kind, doing kindness to people, it's meaningful. You enjoy the result of positive change. So that will reinforce the ABC. Yeah, same as you. The consequence, you enjoy the consequence, you enjoy the change, right?
Be the 12th step.
Yeah, you see, you enjoy, see, if you really practice 8, 1, 2, 3, then the change will become self-reinforcing. That they don't need to depend on you for prior reinforcement anymore. When they do it, they like it, they do more, they like it more, become self-reinforcing. So this ABCD is more powerful than the old ABCD. You know why? Because it does not blame the victim. You know, sometimes I find everybody so mean, you know. Blame everything, so this cognitive dysfunction, you know, like what is the family problem, societal problem, everything blame to get something wrong with thinking. It's so cruel sometimes, I feel, you know. I'm gonna kick his ass. But it's just always blame victim. I see some of the tapes, you know. Make it put us, you know, like sitting there, so uncomfortable. This is empowering. It begins with your weaknesses. Don't worry, believe that you can be better. Believe, see, you can be more handsome. You can be more beautiful.
Can I be taller?
You know, wear platform shoes. you can go through extreme surgery. So the belief is very powerful. I'm not kidding. I'm not lying to you. You can actually do it, you know? Like a program to actually realize that new goal. You see? So I'm not fooling you. I'm not cheating you. I'm saying that what you believe, okay, let's turn that into reality with baby steps. Now, what can we do? What can we do? Eh? You tell me what you want to do. You keep a journey, keep a diary, okay? Let me know how it works out. What do you plan to do this week? We sit down, come up with a plan. Right? A plan. A chart, reinforcement chart, right? Stars. Huh? Yeah. But based on meaning, based on purpose, right? So that's why. Oh, tell me, okay. So that's why it always works. I mean, people throw at me all kinds of cases. I always show them how the ABCD works. You ever else can do that, I can do better. You know, because this, it always works. You know, I don't care what situation. The key is second part. They always say, oh, this person is hopeless. This happened, that happened, that happened. No way you can get him all up from step one, step two. Step two is most difficult. But initially, as long as the person is not killing himself, is not committing suicide, he must believe in something. He must have believe in something. You know, either a children, or believe in nature, or believe in flowers, or believe in... It must believe in some values. Or believe in his ancestry, believe in honor, whatever. There's no such thing a person has no value whatsoever. So the trick is find out what is that one thing that he really believes in. That's a trick, right? What do you really believe in? It's the basic value. What's the basic value that he learned from childhood or somewhere? Everybody has some values. That's why you make choices, right? You make choices because you have values. Your $10 you spend on one thing, not another. Why? Because some value system. Don't tell me no value. Not possible. So once you get sort of be, then C is a lot easier. The B is the most difficult part. To switch from a like a quantum shift. The A is all negative, you know, A is all black. The B is really turning the corner. The began, you know, the Chinese people saying that, you know, the Chinese poem say, you know, San Qun, the Chinese poem saying that you walk, and if you reach the end, you know, there's no more hope. Then turn around, there's another village, you know, open up. You know, as if, you know, but the kids turn around, one more extra step. You're able to take one more step, one extra step, or look at things differently. Just step back, looking up, okay? Just detach yourself a little bit. Once you're able to achieve that, things begin to turn. That's a crucial point. So that is same to 12 steps, number two step, right?
Came to believe that a power greater.
Yeah. Something that can change him. Yeah. So go home and try the ABCD on your clients. If it doesn't work, money back, guarantee. Money back guarantee. If you do it properly, it always works. I've been, you know, tested all over the world. You know, people test me, okay? They threw all kinds of cases at me. Yeah. Because that's based on human nature. Yeah? So it works based on human nature. People want to believe in something. People are desperate to believe in something. They believe in Beatles. They believe in Elvis Presley. They want to believe in anything. Everyone to believe in something. That's the way we are made. Oh. Well, this is how, show how so I think that this how show you how meaning is incorporated into solution, focus strategy. Okay, Okay, now I have developed an instrument called strategic optimism. Here are five steps to restore hope in hopeless situations. Again, it begins with acceptance, affirmation, okay? Now, courage. Courage, that's something I did not talk about in the ABCD. This courage part, because we have to recognize, that courage is the hinge, is the center that everything else has. It takes a lot of courage for Ken to apologize to your father. It takes a lot of courage for me to be to go around the campus and apologize to everyone. It took courage for me to look in the mirror, say, Paul Wong, you're old and ugly. It took courage to say, to admit your shortcomings. So courage is a motivation, is a basic element of motivation that you need for change. Now, this is not part of ABCD, that there's something of a hope. To be able to hope requires courage. Once you take away courage, and then, you know, that's it, you know? So you cannot have recovery without courage. So where does courage come in 12 step? So here is my take, okay? My take is that courage is not the absence of fear. Courage is the capacity to move forward in spite of fear. So, you know, okay, so that, so courage is a virtue. That's part of my argument with the positive psychology. American, either or. For my Oriental positive psychology, it's always either and, okay? Fear and courage. It's not either or, okay? So courage exists because of the existence of fear. So you cannot talk about courage without fear. It's meaningless, right? Oh, I have courage, there's nothing I'm afraid of. What? Courage means nothing. But you are free. Then courage means something. Right? So the courage is a virtue. It's part of the virtue, you know, my positive existential psychology. It courage requires the presence of fear and cowardice. I'm scared. I'm real coward. But I do it. I've done it. See? I'm scared, but I've done it. That's a trigger, right? I mean, I don't care how scared you are. The key is you do it. Action, right? So this understanding, so this courage is all pervasive, is a hinge, is the centerpiece. Everything revolves around courage. So for existential psychology, so we need to help people understand what courage is. And far from his past, all the courageous things he had done I remind him he can do more. Because you can't survive until now without having human courage. How you survive until now without having demonstrated some courage? Right? You all have demonstrated, experienced fear and overcoming fear. You all have experiences of accomplishing something in spite of this fear of failure. Now here's different again, from, I'll give you an example of Chinese psychology, American psychology, okay? Remember the Michigan gang, you know, the Atkinson, you know, gang, you know, in the old days, the Michigan gang, you know, Atkinson, you know, Richard Atkinson, the whole gang about achievement motivation. Remember the old approach avoidance motivation? They say, achievement society, McClellan and Richard Atkinson again, okay? Achieve motivation equal to approach minus avoidance. Remember that? They have this approach avoidance curve drawn. So the net courage, the net approach is the strength approach minus the strength avoidance. That's what Michigan said. This is what the little Wong said. The Wong here, okay? The little Chinese guy Wong says, the Chinese fellow said, the net strength of approach is approach plus avoidance. The most famous lawyer in Canada is Greenspan. He is the most famous criminal defense lawyer, criminal lawyer. To ask him, he said, Mr. Greenspan, how come you're so successful? You're winning almost every case. He said, I'm successful because I'm more scared of losing than anybody else. I'm terrified about losing the case. So I work double hard. I work harder than anybody else. I check all the precedents. I think about different angles. I put in more effort. You know why? Because I'm only want to win, but I'm afraid of success. So his motivation is doubly stronger than people only want to succeed, not afraid of failure. That's my point, right? So that's why I say my positive psychology is the negative and positive are not. It can be combined, can be synchronized, can be integrated to produce more positive. Now come courage. The stronger the fear, the greater the courage. See, same idea. The stronger the fear of failure, the stronger the achievement motivation. The stronger the fear, the stronger the courage. Courage grows the fear. The greater the fear, the greater the courage. So that's the point. So therefore, everybody has gone through that, right? So all we need to do is remind people how they've gone through, right? Aha, you're afraid, you're terrified, but you've gone through it. You succeeded, right? Good for you. Want to do one more time. Right? So therefore, we need courage to guide people through acceptance phase. We need courage to guide people through the belief phase. Is that how it works? So courage is simply an additional ammunition, additional source of motivation that you can use to help people to achieve acceptance and affirmation. Okay? Now, number four. Here, I separate faith, religious faith, or spiritual faith, apart from affirmation, because make affirmation a lot easier, okay? In the ABCD paradigm, belief includes faith, right? But here, for restoring hope, all people do is to say yes to life. that I want to say. You know, but I don't get through other things. Say yes to life. Say yes. You want to live or you want to die? When the, I'm kind of that. I'm trying to differentiate. I'm trying to differentiate between affirmation and faith. Okay, affirmation simply say yes to life. Okay, now after affirmation of life, then you need something. Then you need something more than just affirmation. You need to believe in something, right? Believe something bigger than yourself. Okay, now, same thing like higher power, okay? Same like AA, you need faith in something bigger than yourself. That could be God, as you see it. It could be nature. It could be your tribe. It could be your family. You need to believe in something greater than yourself. That's the key. So now here, I make job easier for people, but say, well, right now you're bad. You're bad. But please don't kill yourself. Like a tsunami or Katrina disaster, okay? Or Iraq, I mean, like Lebanon. Horrible things happening, right? So when you do crisis counseling or intervention, things are bad, right? But first thing to do is you want to make the situation safe, right? Create some safety for them. But the next thing to do is to let them to believe, to affirm that things will get better. Not horrible. Without involving any beliefs, just to affirm, take a more positive view, say things can get better. Okay? Don't give up yet. Don't give up on the government yet. Don't give up on God yet. Don't give up yourself yet. Just hang on a bit longer. Hang on a bit longer. Okay? Hope is coming. Hope is coming. Just hang there. Don't give up. Not so soon. Just hang on a bit longer. Affirmation. Say yes to life. Say yes to life. Say yes to tomorrow. Say yes to possibilities. Say yes to possible change. Just a bit longer. This is a lot easier than getting to believe, right? The easiest thing is just to say affirmation of belief. Now, once you get the faith thing, in order to sustain this affirmation, you need something to believe in, right? In order to sustain this affirmation, you need something to believe in, something bigger than yourself. Okay. You follow me now, okay? So everything shared is multiplied. Everything shared is multiplied, right? Everything shared with you, everything shared is multiplied. You get more. So that's why I'm happy of being generous. My wife says I'm a sucker, okay? But that's okay. People don't always repay me or reward everyone. But, you know, you can see in the conference, many people work long hours helping me out, all right? Working with me, all right? So everything shared is multiplied. Everything kept and calculated and kept will eventually die. You know? Just like a Dead Sea, you know? Dead Sea is Dead Sea because it's not spreading out, you know, to other places.